Ashley.
Hello, Elaine. I'm back.
Hard day at the office?
Oh, I had a hard day at the office.
What are you listening to?
I bought a Walkman.
I can see that. What are you listening to?
Oh, nothing. I just wear it so as I won't look too peculiar in shops when I go like that.
I bought a new recipe book. Do you fancy something Japanese tonight?
Yeah. Let's have a Honda.
What's that?
What's the fun?
Well, I've heard about bringing work home from the office, Ashley, but do you think you should be bringing the furniture back as well?
It's not from the office. I found it.
Where?
At the garage. Someone had left it by one of the pumps.
Well, shouldn't you hand it in?
Well, yeah. I'll do it in the morning. I'm too tired to go around there now.
Is it working?
I don't know. Haven't tried it.
Who do you think it belongs to? Someone important?
Well, yeah, somebody who thinks they're important. Some poser.
You're really saying that because you haven't got one.
No, I'm not. I don't need a portable phone stuffed down my underpants to prove I'm a big success.
I certainly wouldn't ring you if you did.
These status symbols mean nothing to me. It's people with nothing to say phoning up people with nothing better to do than to listen to them.
Look, it's going to take me a while to cook the meal. Why don't you take it down to the police station?
No, I'll do it tomorrow. Won't hurt them to be disconnected for one night, will it? Well, I think I'll have a shower.
Well, don't dilute your beer.
Oh, and if anyone calls me, Miss Walker, tell them I'm out to lunch.
Business as usual, then, eh? Come on, let's ring someone up.
No.
Who do we know long distance? I know, let's ring Australia. How many hours ahead of us are they?
Thought they're about 10 years behind.
I'll ring up Alan. They'll never know it was us.
No. Elaine, it's theft. It's a criminal offence.
Well, you're getting very proper in your old age.
Well, I'm trying to read my book.
Spoiled.
Oh, come on, let's go to bed, eh? You know what they say, an hour before midnight's better than 3 hours after.
I always thought it was a drink before and a cigarette after.
Who can that be?
Well, answer it and find out.
No, you answer it.
Well, you answer it. You found it.
Well, what do they want?
Well, to speak to the person whose phone it is, probably. Go on, answer it.
What shall I say?
Try hello. Go on.
Oh, it's stuck. If I'm off.
Well, they might ring back.
Yeah, what if they do? What shall I say?
Well, just explain what happened. That you found the telephone and that you're taking it back tomorrow morning.
Yeah, okay.
Come on, let's go to bed.
Yeah. It's ringing again?
Well, answer it this time.
Well, go on then.
Ashley?
Well, what do I do? Hello? No, it isn't, actually. No, not at the moment. You see what happened? I found the... Sorry? Hello?
What did they say?
Well, it was all a bit strange. Sort of... weird.
You're still worried about that phone call?
He said, hello, is that Harry? Can you do a job? And then he must have assumed he had a wrong number and hung up.
And it was definitely a man's voice.
Well, it was either that or a woman on 40 Hamlet a day, yeah.
But what did he sound like?
Well, he sounded sort of sinister, you know, like, hello, Harry, like that.
Actually, that's not sinister, that's warped.
Yeah, well, he did. He sounded criminal. I mean, you could hear his tattoos on the other end of the phone.
I think you and your imagination are running away with each other.
Now, let's just work this out. Let's say that this tabletop is the garage forecourt, right? And that this teapot is the petrol pump. And that this cup is the car. And I'm this spoon, right?
No argument so far.
We'll say that the telephone is... well, the telephone, right? So, I drive into the garage. This is me here.
In your teacup.
And I get out and fill up the car from the teapot. There. When all of a sudden...
An unmarked van draws up and two men in white coats rush out with the straitjackets.
I find the telephone here.
Which, by a strange quirk, is bigger than a petrol pump.
Elaine, please. So, I bring the telephone back to the flat here.
We'll just pretend the flat's the flat, shall we? And I'll pretend to be me.
And we're about to go to bed when suddenly the telephone rings. Now, it rings twice. Can you just write that down?
Yes, Sergeant.
Now, the first time, we don't answer it, but the second time, we do. And when we do, a man's voice asks for Harry. So, obviously, Harry is the one who left the telephone...
Exhibit A.
...in the garage forecourt. Now, what do we know about Harry? We know two things. One, he forgot his telephone, so he's absent-minded. And two, he is driving a car. So, now we have a description. We are looking for someone with a poor memory driving a car.
And there can't be too many of those around.
Now, this caller. We'll call this caller Mr. X.
Mr. X?
Right, now, Mr. X asks Harry if he can do a job. Now, what can we deduce from this?
That Harry does jobs?
Good, right. You are learning. So, Harry does jobs. Now, the question is, what sort of jobs does Harry do? Dirty jobs or clean jobs? Little jobs or big jobs?
Sorry.
Right, now, let's just assume that this sugar bowl is one of Harry's jobs.
Ashley, this is getting beyond it. I'm going to bed.
Elaine, you didn't hear the voice on the other end of that phone. It sounded like he was with the mafia or something. I mean, yeah, we could have infiltrated a drugs ring. Or there could be a contract out on somebody.
Who'd he get in touch with, Ashley? There's someone I'd like to take a contract out on.
Elaine, somebody's life could be in danger and all you... It's ringing.
I can hear it.
Right. Okay. Hello?
What are you speaking like that for?
I'm disguising my voice.
Yeah? Harry speaking. Yeah, well, I've just got a bit of a frog in my throat in a moment.
Frog? Sounds like you've got the whole pond.
Yeah? A job? Yeah, I'm interested. Go on. Yeah. Milson Street. Yeah. Junction East. Right. Yeah. Right.
Get the A to Z.
Yeah. White Sierra Cosworth. Yep. Okay. Right. See ya.
Right. Let's get the Batmobile on the road.
Do you think the hat and the sunglasses are really necessary, Ashley? I mean, the trench coat's bad, isn't it?
It's kind of cold, isn't it?
Looks like fancy dress to me.
That'll be all happening in a minute.
Mm. The nights I've heard you say that.
Well, the car's there. White Sierra Cosworth, just like he said.
Yeah, it's not doing much, though, is it? Oh, come on, Ashley. We've been here for half an hour and nothing's happened. Nothing's going to happen.
We'll just give it another 5 minutes. That's romantic, this.
Oh, yeah. It's like Gone with the Wind all over again.
That's a bit like moonlighting on a stakeup. Or Casablanca. Yeah. I'm Humphrey Bogart and you're Ingrid Bergman, eh?
Here's looking at you, kid.
Strange.
Something's happening, look.
Where?
What the? Let him see. Okay.
Won't take long now.
Yeah, good.
What are they doing?
Okay. Done it.
Do you see that?
My case notes. Well, it all seems pretty open and shut to me.
You think so?
Well, what do you think?
I think I should be in bed. That's what I think.
Look, it was in the newspaper and everything. But police warn of a car ring operating in London stealing upmarket cars to order. They are known as the High Performance Mob. And look, that's who this phone belongs to. High Performance Harry.
You sure it's nothing to do with over-imaginative Ashley? You wouldn't think you've just read one too many detective novels, do you?
No. I think I've just cracked a stolen car ring.
Good. Then let's tell the police about it and go home.
Well, we can't just leave it at that.
Why not? What are we, vigilantes?
Well, no, but... Well, we're in the neighbourhood watch.
You told me earlier you thought the Mafia was involved. Do you really think the right people to deal with the Mafia are a neighbourhood watch?
Well, we can't just walk away from it. I mean, Hercule Poirot doesn't go down to the country mansion and find dead bodies everywhere and say, aye, aye, somebody's been murdered, I think I'll go home now. Well, what do you suggest, then?
I've suggested it. Go home. What do you suggest?
Well, we could consult one of the finest minds in the sphere of criminal investigation.
And who's that? Rumpole of the Bailey?
Next best thing. Come on.
Actually, it's 1:30 in the morning.
Justice never sleeps.
Hey, Ashley?
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Yeah. Thanks. Now then, let's start again. It wasn't very corpus mentis the first time. Look, just go back to the beginning, Ashley.
Okay. Well, let's say that this tabletop is a garage forecourt, right? And that this teapot is the petrol pump. And, well, this shoe is my car, right? And this earring...
Yeah, Ashley, when I said go back to the beginning, I didn't mean the origin of the species. Just tell me about the car.
Well... what was that?
What?
That?
It's the cat.
Oh. Anyway, what I wanted to ask you, Percy, whether you...
It's ringing.
Well, answer it.
No, you answer it.
Well, you answered it last time.
Well, it's your turn, then.
Well, they'll expect to hear the same voice, won't they? They'll think it's a bit strange if Harry's turned into a woman.
Look, someone answer, for God's sake, otherwise you'll wake the cat.
Okay. Hello?
What's he talking like that for?
Frogs.
Yeah? Oh, yeah, I got delayed. Too much heat about. Yeah? A roller? Yeah, I'm interested. Go on. A40, yeah. Junction. Right. Okay. Yep. Oh, I'll be there. Yeah. Bye. Well, what are we waiting for?
The A40, actually, that's miles away.
Purse?
Well, it's like this, Ash. Thing is, I've got to feed the cat.
Well, you can just leave it something in a bowl, can't you? I mean, it'll be all right. Oh, come on, you two. Don't be so stuck in the mud. Oh, Purse, come on. Don't you want an adventure? An exciting new experience?
I thought I was having one till you told me.
What did you say?
No, nothing, nothing, no. Look, the truth is, Asya, I just write a note for the cat.
Nothing's happened. Come on, let's go home.
No, in a minute. Look, you can't rush surveillance. You've got to have patience. I wonder who this Harry really is.
I wonder how my bed is.
Yeah. I wonder how my cat is. It's ringing. Here, maybe further instructions. Shh.
Hello? Yeah?
No, I don't want to buy any double glazing, thank you.
No! No, thank you.
Flipping telephone canvases, they get everywhere. I mean, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm gonna go ex-directory.
Actually, look.
Yeah. Heads down.
What's going on?
Adam's opening the bonnet. He's hot wiring the engine.
See? Told you, it's the high performance mob.
They've started it.
Right, Elaine, put your seatbelt on. Right. Purse, hold on in the back.
Right, what's he doing?
I'm giving chase.
Giving chase? It's a Rolls Royce.
Don't you worry. I've brought my driving gloves.
Can I use this phone to make a call, Ashley? I'm a bit worried about my cat. I might have woken up and found I'm not there, you see. I'll just ring it up and tell it I'm all right.
How's a cat going to answer the phone? Right, here we go.
Ashley!
I'll just put it into overdrive.
Overdrive? We haven't even got third.
Well, we almost caught him.
Almost caught him? Ashley, us trying to keep up with that Rolls Royce was like a budgie trying to overtake Concorde. I mean, all the way to Slough in the middle of the night. I wouldn't even want to go to Slough in the daytime.
What time is it?
7:30 a.m.
You know, it's funny, Purse didn't want to come back for breakfast. And he seemed very worried about his cat.
Ashley, Joyce was there.
No, she wasn't, was she?
Yes, her things were all over the place.
Well, I didn't notice.
Hardly surprising. You were too busy with your investigations to notice anything as trivial as the obvious.
Well, if I'm going to the office, I suppose I'd better go and have a shave. Hey, it's another one.
Oh, no. No, I'm not going out again, Ashley. Don't answer it.
Yeah, it might be another job.
Ashley, don't answer it.
Hello?
Oh. Hello.
Who is it?
It's Harry. I tell you what, I'll hide behind the door. You hit him with a ketchup bottle.
No, I tell you what. I'll hide behind the door with a big yellow streak down my back and we beg for mercy. How's that? Oh, why ever did you give him our address?
Well, so he could collect his phone.
Well, you should have got his address and we could have taken it round.
Oh, I thought you didn't want to go out again.
But I don't want some criminal hard case coming round here. If he thinks we're on to him, he's not going to be too pleased about it. He might not come on his own.
Well, you don't think he'd bring the rest... It's him. It's high performance.
Just give him the phone and tell him to go.
Hello? Hello?
Harry Ward. I rang about my phone.
Come in.
Morning, missus. I hope I didn't wake you.
No, that's all right. We were up anyway.
Oh, your phone.
Thanks. Don't know why I didn't think of it sooner, to ring my own number. It's obvious, really, isn't it? Been worried sick all night. Where did I leave it?
Well, at the filling station. I was going to hand it in this morning.
Oh, yeah, of course. Weren't any calls, were there?
Well...
I run a little garage operation, see? 24-hour call-out. I get into cars people have rocked themselves out of, sports cars and that. Surprising how many lose their keys. You'd think they'd be a bit more careful.
I see.
Still, if they couldn't get me, they'd have got my partner instead. I'm just glad to get it back at all. Do I owe you...
Oh, no, no, really, no.
Oh, it's very good of you. Because it's a few hundred quid's worth, this phone, you know? Mm. It's not everyone who's honest these days.
Yes, there are so many around with a criminal mentality.
Thanks again, Lynn. Bye-bye.
Oh, right, yes, bye. Bye. Mm.
Well then, Sherlock, the way I see it is this. This boiled egg is your head. And this spoon is a very large mallet. And... here's looking at you, Humphrey. High performance Harry.
Well, I wasn't to know. Anyway, at least we had an adventure, didn't we?
No, we had a misunderstanding. And the only adventures I want from now on are armchair ones.
Oh, yeah. Armchair and Slumberland.
Capital News Update, I'm Chris Cardell. It appears the high-performance mob struck again during the night when a Rolls-Royce at a Sierra Cosworth were reported missing. The police are looking for a young man and woman in a Citroen 2CV.
I'll hide the car.
I'll close the blinds.
Elaine?
Yes?
Don't answer the phone.
There's another session with those two, the same time, 7:30 tomorrow. Coming up, Arthur and Terry get mixed up with a superstar. Oh yeah, heard that one before. Minder is next here on Plus.